How to stick breadcrumbs together to create a slice of bread using a spider's web of idiots. Hello, guys, and welcome to the ultimate exposure of the Cebu pimp that is Karate Marty. Before we start this, I have to tell you that this is about to get crazy. And I mean crazy. So pause this video, make a brew, and grab a pen and paper, so you can stick the crumbs together also using this spider's web of idiots, as we move along this expose of the Cebu pimp Karate Marty. Now, Marty, this is all public record, and to sue me, you'd have to prove its falseness in a court of law, and I'm willing to take it there. Also, Marty, by what I'm about to do, I know by exposing what I'm about to expose, I could potentially put my life in danger, but I'm a British man, Marty, and you're a traitor to the values and morals we possess, and to do the right thing, Marty, is the British way. You're the worst man I've ever researched in my entire life, and I'll risk it all to expose you for what you are. I digress. Now, we must start this off with just who is Karate Marty. So Karate Marty, also known as Martin Royal, was born in Staffordshire, England in 1974 and grew up on Sesame Street in Greater Manchester with his boyfriend Ernie wearing little rainbow t-shirts and fighting in the underground Kumite tournaments. Only joking, but he did grow up in Manchester and born Staffordshire, and is 49 years old, recently turned and weighing in at over 17 stone, and is 6'4" tall. Now, I must admit that the earlier years have managed to stay quite hidden, although we do have this.
Jimmy Japan, that's a bad thing to say, isn't it? When I got to college, all the black kids were my friends. Well, they were after a while. At first, they all wanted to kill me. They didn't like me because I went to their Beastmasters, where Pele Reed was ran on the race course, and it was all the black lads like Ashley Gishard, Gordon MacDonald, all them. So when I walked in, they hated a white guy going in there with confidence. They always wanted to kill me, but then we become friends. Apart from one of them, the world champion, he hated me. We still don't get on to this day.
Now, who is Ashley Gishard? Well, Ashley is one serious guy, and when I say serious, I mean legit one scary motherfucker. Ashley is a former world champion kickboxing fighter and had his career cut short due to an injury to his arm during a car crash, and is currently a digital creator with over 5,000 follows on Facebook, and is a Muay Thai instructor living and instructing Muay Thai in Greater Manchester, and has a very successful gym that even the likes of Logan Paul has visited and trained at. But Ashley has a very crazy past, from being involved in murders to arson, drugs, blackmail, and violence, but two cases sticks out more than the rest. Case one, he was acquitted of the murder of Brian Waters, a father of two, who was brutally murdered at Burnt House Farm that was apparently ordered by a drugs baron, and the father didn't just get shot. They tortured him for hours and even stapled staples into his head multiple times with an industrial staple gun and killed him by stuffing a metal bar up his rectum, and this was apparently to steal his cannabis he had growing. Now, I'm no angel, and I know people who know people like we all do, and I know of cannabis robberies, but does stapling a man's head and shoving a bar up his arse after hours of torture sound like a normal robbery to you? Case 2. Ashley was hired by a man named Tommy Roy to set fire to a man's car in Manchester over a £30,000 debt, where Tommy said to the man, "I will fuck you up now. You do not know who you are messing with. I will fuck you up and put you in that skip." The day after the arson, he was found with two samurai swords and a machete in his car and jailed for 6 years. Now Tommy's wife Victoria works for the BBC, and is the lady behind such shows like Junior Doctors, Dragon's Den, and A Question of Sport, you may recognize her. Now notice the expensive seats that they're sat on in this picture. They are seats from the Circle nightclub in Greater Manchester, a four-star private members nightclub for the rich and famous. And rich and famous is an understatement for just who attends this bar. Justin Timberlake was once refused entry for not owning a membership, and they knew who he was. Royalty, football players, politicians, BBC and TV channel bosses, and many socialites. So we found out that Martin Royal grew up with Ashley and Tommy in Greater Manchester and has a connection to the Circle nightclub in Greater Manchester. I may seem to have gone off track here from Marty, but this will happen a few times throughout this exposé. But stay tuned, because it will all create the spider's web of idiots. But I mention this because it will become more relevant later on. So this is crumb number one. So write this down with your pen and paper. 1. Ashley Gishard, brutal murder and torture. 2. And his best friend Tommy Roy, whose wife works for Channel 4 Studios. 3. Ashley Gishard, digital creator. 4. Karate Marty is a bitch. 5. Karate Marty has connections to the Circle nightclub in Greater Manchester. Karate Marty would go on to fake that he had studied 7 years to achieve a HND certification in business studies, and then followed his BA Hans degree in business enterprise innovations and communication, and would start a company named Iceberg Media, which is registered at 14 Commercial Street, Manchester, M154PZ, with his business partner and wanking buddy Hans Koch, where they would launch their company with a big human trafficking prostitution party. Along with a few SEO companies. Now, what is an SEO company and who is Hans Koch? I'll start with what is an SEO company. SEO means search engine optimization website company. It is a professional and very often shady service that aims to improve a website's visibility and ranking in search engine results, meaning your website will reach higher rankings on Google. They use various techniques and strategies to optimize a website's structure, content, and external factors to increase its chances of appearing higher in search engine results pages. However, there are instances where SEO companies can be involved in scams, the most famous being Jordan Belfort, known as the Wolf of Wall Street. One common scam tactic is making exaggerated promises of quick and guaranteed results while not delivering results, or using shady black hat practices. They may claim that they have exclusive access to secret SEO techniques or special relationships with search engines like Google. In reality, legitimate SEO practices require ongoing efforts, quality content creation, and adherence to search engine guidelines. Another scam tactic is using questionable techniques like black hat SEO, which means the evil side of hacking. This includes practices such as keyword stuffing, hidden text, cloaking, or buying low-quality backlinks to manipulate search engine rankings. While they may initially bring some results, search engines are constantly evolving and improving their algorithms to detect these manipulative techniques. Once getting caught, a website can often face severe penalties, including being completely removed from search results. But these companies can also be used as a front to network a certain demographic of business and like-minded people, but can also be used and are very often used to network disguise and underground trade online, like the sale of drugs, weapons, prostitution, pedophilia, and any other business you can think of, underground and legal. Now this, my friends, was crumb number two. So grab that pen and paper and write the next link in this spider's web of idiots. 1. SEO companies network and group together like minded people of a certain trade. 2. Martin and Hans Koch own Iceberg Media. 3. Karate Marty is a bitch. 4. SEO companies can network prostitution and pedophiles together in disguise. As I write this script to this video, I've been racking my brains and researching for more crumbs to add to this spider's web of idiots. And I was sitting here staring at my notepads with my head in the clouds, and then, bang! It hits me like a fucking ton of bricks, and I can't explain to you how angry I am right now. I have tears on my cheek as I write this from what you are about to find out. Now I joke, and will still joke to keep you engaged and not get so angry at what is coming, but I do not find this funny whatsoever. Here's breadcrumb number three and what I just noticed. Iceberg Media is a video entertainment company that specializes in creating videos, and it seems that it's still a registered company online with a rating of nearly 4 stars, and the reviews are mostly 50-50 good and bad. But most of the reviews are not registered with Google. Odd, isn't it? Considering this company hasn't updated its website in years and has no social media with any relevance. Now take a look at Iceberg Media's company logo. It's an iceberg that's mostly underwater. Strange thing to use, isn't it, for a media company? Nothing video or media about it? So do you know what this means? Have you not seen this iceberg before? No, it's an online reference to the deep, dark, and light web. Everything above water is the normal web, like Google, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and all the normal stuff, and everything underneath the water is the deep and dark web. It's a reference for you can't see it. Google the dark web iceberg and look at the images. Now that was crumb number three, so grab your pen and write. 1. Iceberg Media uses the dark web reference as its logo. 2. It's a media company that makes distributes and sales video content. 3. It's also an SEO company that networks. 4. Karate Marty is a bitch. 5. Has a 4-star rating with dubious comment history and no website updates or relevant social medias. You'll see how and why and what that means soon. There is going to come a time during this exposé where it all fits and clicks, and your mind is going to crack like an egg with pure anger, rage, and empathy. Now I ask each and every one of you to not react in a stupid way with what you're about to hear here and use your brains. After this is exposed, I'm personally going to the police and ask you to also. If it means exposing myself to you all, then I will do that, but I ask you when this is finished to keep digging and digging and spread this like you couldn't imagine, cause I'm about to expose something that's worse than where your mind is already going. What you are thinking times it by a million, and you're still not close to what's coming up when it all fits together and creates the spider's web of idiots. Marty's SEO companies are all aimed at just working with escorts and people in the sex trade, and Karate Marty's SEO Escorts has a Facebook, and on that Facebook are profile pics and background pics, but some in particular stuck out to me. Escorts on top and Indigo Blue. We'll start with Indigo Blue, and its Twitter page, which has the profile pic of Escorts on top. Notice the branding and colors and layout of SEO Escort, and we'll compare it to the Indigo Blue logo. Well, would you look at that? The idiots have used the same branding on both businesses. Now, why would you do that? Would it be because Karate Marty's SEO Escorts company is a front for networking like-minded people of a certain trade? No, surely not. Seems strange that his business is doing so well, but yet hasn't posted on the company Twitter's page since August in 2017, and has no likes, no comments, nothing. And it gets stranger when you notice that 99% of the followers of this account are brothels based around the UK. But back to Indigo Blue. Now Indigo Blue hasn't uploaded since 2014. But as you can see, every post is advertising women in the sex trade and potential trafficked humans from around the world. But there is more. As we keep digging, we start to look through the followers list, and you'll notice that everyone is a man. But look, wait, what's that? It's another page with similar branding. Now, what would be the odds that that page advertises women in Manchester? No way, surely not Karate Marty. Boom, we found your Twitter page, Marty. And oh look, you were advertising in July last year. Can you see it yet? Let's take a deeper dive at what Karate Marty sells, shall we? And he words his posts to attract his clientele that he knows so well. Newness. Stunning Manchester babe, honey. New pics of stunning busty brunette Carmen, available for Northwest visits. New teen companion starts tomorrow. Call and ask for 18-year-old honey in Manchester. This Twitter page has many women in the sex trade following it with their customers only following them, and each have around 20 to 60 followers, all men on every one. But everyone following this page are all women. I feel these women are Marty's employees and their followers are his clients. Now you may say, but Tron, the branding alone doesn't mean that Marty is the owner of all these Twitter pages and many more. But we'll add some crumbs onto the spider's web of idiots and tighten the noose on Marty's fate. Secret Directories has the same similar colored branding, but also is based out of Manchester. But not only that, Marty can't help but gloat about his YouTube success and mention that he's actually a social media influencer, but look at the area code of the phone numbers and take a note, and also take a note of the 0203 number on the SEO escorts page. Strange number for a company based in Britain, hey guys and girls. Well, the 020 prefix denotes London areas, with a virtual landline providing virtual numbers for businesses and individuals around the UK. i.e. numbers that look like they ring one area but will intact be transferred to another area virtually like your IP address when using a VPN. But still you could say, but it's not definitive that Karate Marty is running a sleazy escort agency out of Cebu City that seems to cater to a certain individual. Well, let's hear what Hasdeka Hegi has to say about it.
Well, how are you doing, everyone? Good morning to the UK. I just thought I'd put out a little video. I've got some more revelations to make. I'll be prepared. And like I say, anything I say is no lie. It's the truth. And if Martin wants to test me on the lies, then he can get me done for defamation, can't he? Because nothing I say is a lie. But anyways, Martin's SE4 tradesman. Business company, yeah? What does he do? Escorting business, yeah? Now Martin has the business registered in the UK, yeah? Or so he wants you to believe. But like I said, I have nothing to lose now, and especially the things that he's saying about me coming on social media claiming that I'm grooming 18-year-old girls. You mean the 18-year-old girls that work for you? Yeah. As I say, Marty, you like them young, yeah? People can say what they want. 18-year-old. I'd never go with an 18-year-old bird. I'm nearly 40 years of age. What do you want with an 18-year-old? And what do you want with 18-year-olds working for you? Got a lot of explaining to do, Martin. You need to address all this anyway. Hello, thank you. The thing is, what I don't understand is, why is he coming out with all these accusations against me when I've got so much on him?
The main reason I never ever came out was because I didn't want my kids getting trolled. I've had to speak to them last week. And they know what's happening. It's been old enough now. 14, 16, 26. I've kind of let them know what's happening, and I'm kind of worried about it a bit, but and I've got every right to be worried, because I know the extent this has went to previously, other people and their kids. And I've been accused of, like, telling somebody's brother who's got a rape of children.
Okay, the reason he's got no money is because he earns what money he does get in the holiday season. Holiday season, December. Martin's SE4 tradesman, or his escort business, sells young ladies to foreign men. Okay? Martin gets 35% of what the girls make. Yeah? Even his wife doesn't even know this. He thinks he's made out to his wife it's some sort of, I don't know, he's probably told her that it's an escort business in the UK. I've never heard him speak about it in front of her, but I do know that he's not registered over here in the Philippines, and he is, well, as I say, pimping girls out. But he seems to always want to get the 18-year-olds. He seems, this is Martin's words, 18-year-olds are better because they're pure. Some of them are pure, and some of them haven't been with any men, which the foreigners will pay more money for. Mate, you're an absolute delusional, wrong. Do you know what, when the whole truth comes out, I do hope people see what you are, because at the moment you've got them all licking your ring piece, but knowing that you're a pimp over here, you'll probably get a pass for that as well. But honestly, at the moment, he's done no business when I've been here, because it isn't the holiday season. I have seen the files on a lot of the girls that he's got working for him, and all of them are under 22. That's his preference, the younger the better, he says. All under QT. I wouldn't be surprised if he's not Choco doing it as well, to be honest with you. Wouldn't surprise me. I've not seen a bit of life.
Now, I know what you're going to say, but that's just Decca, and the coincidences are nothing but coincidences, and Humble is innocent, and just on the run, hiding in Cebu City for nothing. You still can't prove that Karate Marty has any registered companies at 14 Commercial Street in Greater Manchester, oh, can't I now?
Hi, guys. Welcome to my channel. And I'm going to show you a house tour of our royal residence. Let's go. Hi, guys. Welcome to our humble home. And this is the front of the house. I know that there are a lot of you been asking lately about the house tour, and here it is. We have here our car and my motorcycle on the other side. We also bought a water tank over there. This helps us for a water supply once there wouldn't have an electricity sometimes in our area. So let's get inside. Hi, babylings. This is my dog, a Doberman Pinscher. She's already 8 years old. And as you can see, this is their living room right now. I know you already noticed about our living room, which is purple on Martin's live all the time. And we have here a customized 18-seater couch, and we really picked color purple again, as it is my favorite and also Martin's favorite color, so that's what we decided to have. So in here, it is an extra storage where all the stuff for the kids, like the console, the controller, any bits for the kids games, I just put it there so easy access. This is the favorite place that we always hang and chill watching movies. As you can see, we have here a 75-inch TV, and we choose this one as we really love watching movies all the time with the kids and Martina. And this is the surround sound. Let's go and see the view in the living room. this is the first bathroom with a shower area. So let's go to the second floor. First room, it's the office of Martino with his rowing machine, the bench, the table, the chair, and as you can see over there, it's the golf clubs. Let's go to the second.
Did you see it? Was you looking? No, you was mesmerized by her voice, wasn't you?
First room, it's the office of Martino with his rowing machine, the bench, the table, the chair, and as you can see over there, it's the golf clubs.
Told you. So let's take a look at what we have so far. Karate Marty and Hans Koch own Iceberg Media Video Creation Company that seems to advertise towards and do most of its business on the dark web. And it doesn't take a genius to work out why they would do this, but most people would do this because they are involved in illegal activity like distributing material aimed towards pedophiles. And then we have the many SEO companies owned by Marty that are fronts for networking clients and escorts from Manchester all the way to the Philippines. And then we have Ashley Guichard and Tommy Roy as Marty's connections to the private member's extremely exclusive Circle nightclub in Greater Manchester. Also, this office is hardly equipped with enough hardware to run any SEO company, let alone four. He doesn't even own a keyboard. But look, he does own four landline phones, though. Why would you need four landline phones, Karate Marty? One for each agency, maybe? Now, all that was to show Marty's operation and how it's run, and if you're still here listening, watching this video, then this is the turning point of the video and things are about to get very dark. Marty is the lackey for a bigger organization that goes by the name of The Circle, and the crumbs we're about to connect are about to get extremely dark, and I ask you to get ready for this entire corner of YouTube to realize we have a serious pedophile ring here, guys, and when I say serious, I mean probably one of the worst pedophile rings on planet Earth. And the investigation that is happening right now worldwide on them is massive. And this about to lead to one specific case in the Philippines that was probably one of the worst cases of pedophilia ever to be caught. But to get there, we have to start with, who is Hans Koch Karate Marty's Iceberg Media business partner? Hans A. Koch is a German man who grew up in America and genuinely does have the accolades that Karate Marty fakes. He is the founder of several companies, which focuses on internet marketing, training, education, and has also served as general manager of WebROI, Diomo.com, and TrafficSupport.net Asian operations, and has spoken at many seminars and conventions around the world, and especially in the IT Business Park in Cebu City in the Philippines.
Today, I'm here at the SEMCON conference, Search Engine Marketing. And I'll talk a little bit about why SEO, search engine optimization, is important. These days, Google is one of the most known brands, most popular brands. And if you can't be found on Google, then you pretty much don't exist. So making sure that your website is found on Google, not only for your brand, but also for your products, your product brands, as well as your keywords that your users, your customers, and your future customers will want to find you. There's a lot of different types of strategies that can help you get on those first pages of Google. Some of those are making sure that you have great content, that you have content that talks about what your products and services are, making sure that you have social media that ties with your brand, and that you update and you follow your customers follow you. It's also important to include those social media links and banners and logos and icons on your website as well as on your signature, on your email signature, as well as on any marketing materials. So they can find you not only on these social networks, but also you'll be picked up on Google a lot sooner as well. One of the more important social medias these days that also helps with your brand is Google Plus. Now Google Plus helps you with local optimization. If you're trying to come up for your local business, your location, your store, etc. But it also helps with your branding as well. Google is becoming is saying that the brand is more important now than, let's say, just a generic company or a generic website. They want the brands. Why? Because the brands they know are going to stay a lot longer, right? You're going to invest more in your brand, in your company website, in your content, than if you're just a fly-by-night company. So branding is becoming more and more important to Google, just as it is to businesses that are in for the long term.
And as an internet aficionado and participated in a widely circulated BBC report regarding his work on click fraud. While Wired magazine profiled his innovative efforts in recreating the first click fraud detection software for whosclickingwho.com. Hans Koch went to San Jose State University and studied business administration with an emphasis in marketing, and currently resides in Bohol in the Philippines with Karate Marty, but was previously in Thailand and where they were running several SEO companies and where Karate Marty met his wife.
I met Jo and I was 37, she was 19. I didn't know her age, she was a woman at work. And here they go to school to 18, so you know the 19 or older. I had no idea. I just saw her, thought she's the most beautiful girl I've ever seen, saw her smile and asked for a date.
But you never met your wife there, did you, Karate Marty? So why would you say that? You met her in Thailand. So what would you need to make a lie? Is it because you realized this? She was 15 if she just left school and was at work, Marty. Let's take another look at the graph, shall we, and see what's new. Now we come to that part of the video again, where we need to take out our pens and write the next crumbs that we will be adding to this spider's web of idiots. 1. Hans Koch is German too. Hans Koch has many pics with random kids on his Flickr account. 3. Karate Marty met his wife at 15, so he's defo a pedophile. 4. He lives in Bohol in the Philippines, and so does Marty. He lives at the top of the Chocolate Hills with a beautiful view over the local landscape. 5. Marty is a bitch. 6. Your mind's about to be taken somewhere you never expected, so get ready, Coz, we're about to get darker. I'd like to read an article to you that I found in the Bohol local newspaper. And remember, Marty is British and Hans is German, and they both live in Bohol, and both run illegal escort agencies and married underage kids, and run a media video creating company that aims its advertising towards dark web content. Now ask yourself, how many duos would be living in that area of Bohol with this amount of connections to this article you're about to hear, and get ready because this is about to be the part. Your mind cracks and you get angry. Bohol women warned on Savage Girl Eyes Circle, Savage Girl, or whatever that pronounces, is her dark web tag name. Circle is the dark net website run by a serious pedophile ring, but where have we heard the name The Circle Club before? Well, you remember earlier where Ashley Gishard and Tommy Roy connected? Karate Marty to the elite private members Circle Club in Greater Manchester. And now you know how Marty did actually meet Wayne Rooney, and now you know how Marty got them two girls so easily for him. Seeing the big picture yet? I digress. The pursuit against the Savage Sexual Predators International Syndicate has not ended with the recent arrest of Savage Gurley. The disclosure of the savage sexual torture of an infant and some girls in the hands of an Australian abuser and his Filipina partner sometime in 2011 and 2012 drew a national outrage. The crime was discovered upon the escape of two of the victims who managed to disclose the location of the crime scene and the exact place where one of the victims who had died a 12-year-old girl was buried after a brutal torture. The 53-year-old Australian mastermind, Peter Gerard Scully, and his 23-year-old Filipina cohort, Liesel Margallo, were arrested in 2015. Margallo was, however, released then in the absence of an arrest warrant against her, while Scully has since been detained in Cagayan de Oro City Jail. Margallo had confessed then that she was part of Scully's savage child pornography business, Savage Girl. I've shortened her name due to it always being written in the article as her dark web tag name, and it contained symbols and would get confusing. She was called Gurley Savage Circle, but using letters and symbols to create the name. She visited Bohol, and Bohol authorities are alarmed upon learning that Margallo had been in Bohol for a vacation in February the previous year. She was with two female friends at Cliffside Resort in Panglao. Activities of some women peddling children for sex in Panglao are also being monitored now. It was sometime in 2011 when some women in Bohol had disclosed that an Australian national had found them in online dating websites. The foreigner allegedly offered to send a cache of gadgets, including expensive Apple MacBooks. But the receiving Filipina should first send a considerable amount for the processing of documents. This was allegedly the test on the vulnerability of the target victim eyed to be groomed as cohorts in a child pornography underground business, since another dirty deal would follow. Allegedly, the alternate offer is for the foreigner to be the Filipina's online boyfriend, and that the Filipina will scout for him, some girls to pose for pornography. Luckily, the women targeted by the foreigner turned down the deal, according to a classified information. NBI authorities who arrested Margallo last week warned the public that a worldwide syndicate is behind Scully. Here we go, guys. These pedophiles come from Brazil, Germany, Australia, and the United Kingdom. That's funny isn't due to there being an underground dark web media company that is run by pedophiles, and one is from the United Kingdom and the other is from Germany, and they pay young girls in the province for sex work and married underage girls. No, it's just a coincidence, isn't it, guys? Surely this corner of YouTube can't be that crazy, or full of an elite underground darknet website and is connected to the elite private members club in Manchester that has a huge pentagram on the floor.
That's a one, Ray. Thank you. Out of his own mouth. Ginger with a child abuse. I've seen a video where he's got his arm round her. I've got a clip somewhere. He's got his arm round kebab flaps. Saying he's even been questioned over satanic child abuse.
No way, Tron, I hear you say you're fucking crazy, Tron, and going to far, and your tinfoil hat is showing. Well, guys and girls, I'm 100% legit. But Tron, his illegal escort agencies and dark web website, and a network of pedophiles and marrying underage kids, and being the only British and German duo in Bohol that escort and trail the province for young girls to escort, and Hans doing a documentary for the wife of the man who grew up with Marty that connects them both to the elite private members circle club in Manchester, and the sign in his office is all just coincidences, and you're crazy, Tron, and there is no way you have more, I hear you say. Oh, I forgot to mention, Peter Scully owned fucking SEO companies in the Philippines, just like Marty and Hans. What a fucking coincidence. But you're still not getting it, are you? You just can't believe that it would be this bad or this insane, or that Pirate Patty Conroy has been telling the fucking truth this whole time! I won't finish this article as it goes into the description of just what happened to Daisy, and to be honest, I don't even want to read it. I need a clear mind to finish this script, but I already feel rage and vengeance like you couldn't imagine. We found us a pedophile ring, guys, but wait, did I just hear you say once again you're fucking gone in the head, Tron? What else you got? Well, would I be Tron if I didn't have more? I digress. Marty and Hans left Thailand for the beautiful chocolate hills of Bohol and flew their underage wives 1,400 miles away from all their family and settled in Bohol. But why? Why would they do that? What would make them do that? Well, it's a double-edged answer, you see. I've seen some of you mention Michael Turner, but you're not asking how the fuck does Marty the Manchester pedo pimp know this German man, or this exiled pedophile murderer Michael Allen Turner. And some of you were so close you couldn't imagine how close you were to revealing it all through Michael Turner. You didn't ask how Martin knew him. You missed it, but Tron found it. Councillor David Royal arrested on suspicion of child rape. A veteran Manchester Labour councillor who's related to Karate Marty has been arrested on suspicion of child abuse. David Royal, 49, who has represented Fallowfield for more than a decade, is being investigated for homosexual activity with a young boy. Greater Manchester Police confirmed the Labour Party backbencher was arrested on July 27th on suspicion of rape of a young boy. He has been bailed until the middle of next month. It is understood senior local labor figures were made aware of the allegation well before the council broke for the summer. A Greater Manchester Police spokesman said, on Monday, July 27, 2015, a 49-year-old man from Fallowfield was arrested on suspicion of sexual activity with a child. He has now been bailed until October 14th, pending further inquiries. Mr. Royal has been a labor councillor for 15 years, at one time serving as the town hall's assistant executive member for the environment. More recently, he has served on the council's licensing and appeals and community scrutiny committees. Labor councillor Royal refused to comment. But Tron, how does David Royal know Michael Allen Turner, I hear you ask? You seen the big picture yet, guys? When I said this ring goes straight to the top, I meant straight to the top. And now we know Marty had a high-profile relative that was a Freemason. But we still haven't looked into Michael Turner, but before we do that, let's take our pens out and write down some more crumbs to add to this spider's web of idiots. 1. Savage girl who worked for the Circle Club and was Peter Scully's wife filmed and created all work out of Bohol. 2. Pedo ring named the Circle. 3. The ring's members contain German and British nationalities. 4. Marty is a bitch 5. Marty had a Freemason relative giving him a connection to Freemasons and Michael Turner, who was a Freemason. So let's take a look at the chart, shall we? Notice how it's all leading back to the Circle Club guys and girls? Now, Michael would invite Karate Marty over to the Philippines, but let's dive into the sociopath pedophile rapist that is Michael Turner. Michael Allen Turner, aged 51, born on March 20th, 1961, of Florida, United States, decided to try his luck in the Philippines in 2003. Having formed intimate ties with Marisol Castillon, he proceeded to help finance Harvest CEO Computer Services, a sole proprietorship company registered under Ms. Castillon. This venture, though, served as a portent for what would be a prevalent trend in everything Michael Allen Turner would do in the country. Things have a habit of ending up in fire, and Harvest SEO did just that. Oh, look, guys, another SEO company, could it be a front again? No, surely not. But SEO Harvest would go broke, and Michael and Marisol Castillon would take different paths, but not due to the company going broke. It was due to Michael trying to touch her inappropriately and forceful. We then lead on to 2006, when another guy by the name of Gus Rodano and several other Filipino colleagues founded Sticky Media Solutions, Inc. After raising the needed capital by pooling together their financial resources and making personal loans in financial establishments. Several weeks later, Michael Turner approached them, asking if Gus Rodano and company can service his clients. In March 2006, Michael Turner engaged the services of Sticky Media Solutions. Michael Turner, who recently suffered a serious financial setback from the failure of his first business venture in the Philippines, did not have a pot to piss in to buy shares in Sticky Media, just a side note. Strange name for another video company that these PPL seemed to involved with. He, however, convinced his clients to make an advance payment to him and in turn paid the company for services rendered. Michael would then go on to claim he had a partnership with Sticky Media. Fast forward to July 2011, and in what appeared to be a string of events that eerily mirrored the Castillon versus Turner saga, the business relationship went down the drain. After 5 years of doing business with Turner and his company, MichaelTurnerHarvestCO.com, Inc., Sticky Media was a few millions in debt. Collectible amounts had accrued due to the partial payments made by Turner. This knowledge, and the fact that Michael Turner refused to rectify the situation, forced Sticky Media into severing the business relationship. Things got complicated before that. Several discussions and negotiations about a merger between both companies, Sticky Media Solutions and Michael Turner. HarvestCO.com were in progress, which started sometime in the early second quarter of 2011. Unfortunately, everything fell apart during the final stretch of the negotiations in July that same year. Sensing that things were not going his way, Michael Turner initiated an unlawful hostile takeover. He accomplished this by purporting that someone left him a death threat. In light of that fabricated scenario, he hired armed personnel from a security agency and covertly changed the locks to all of the doors of Sticky Media on a Sunday when none of the managers were present. As a longtime business associate, Turner was presented a working space within the Sticky Media office and had access to the entry door of the company. He instructed the cadre of security guards he hired to inspect everyone who came and went inside the sticky media. What a prick. And while going about town being nuts because had protection and bodyguards. And to cut a long story short, Michael started a long blog about his rival with many threats and a real hatred online, and would talk absolute crap like this. Now that the elections are over, and I'm packing a Glock 22C and an extra for turnover, and besides the fact that I've never met a security guard that will earnestly pat down a white foreigner, and forget about the fact that the chief of police is my batchmate in the local Rotary Club, and besides the fact that I contribute as appreciation for being so safe in such a beautiful city, guns are not an issue for me. I have mine. No one fucks with me. My point is this. Guns here are not needed if you have the right contacts. If you have the right contacts, you'll have more guns on your side than you can imagine. Speak softly and carry a big stick. But Michael would go on to claim that Sticky Media had stolen his hard-like computers and monitors, and much more, but had no proof whatsoever. Well, would you believe me if I told you Michael was actually on the raid instructing the police what to do and what to take, and the police were taking orders from Michael? No, that can't be true, Tron. How the fuck would you know that?
Ibrantahan sa mga akusado ang pag-apil-apil sa mga sibilyan pauban sa mareklamo si Michael Turner na lakit ng billboard na pagka sa mga gadgets kuban sa mga polis at sa pagronda.
Ang mga monitor, supposedly, ang polis naman unta ang mohimo sa paglawas sa mga butang. There's this one guy who happened to be the brother-in-law of the complainant. Siya may nagpagawas sa mga butang, sa mga monitor. I mean, is that correct?
I wasn't involved in taking any of the things. I was just after the search warrant that was executed.
Oh, really, Michael? So what's this then?
Okay.
Ken.
You need to
take this out here and
get their cell phones.
You're supposed to take their cell phones.
But Tron, I hear you say, what does this have to do with anything? It's just an SEO company and it could have been legit. Well, you can't prove that Michael was running a front company to cover any shady dealings and was just a crazy guy. Oh, can't I? Posted on the Michael Turner blog spot, where many people would post about the many shady dealings of Michael Turner. And one states, so, where is the macho pistolero? He disappeared. I heard tirades and guns and even bombs splashing all over the galaxy that I had to go on hiding for a while in my bunker to avoid any possible ricochet. I read at least 20 posts from him menacing everyone on his way, except Mike Mountstephen, aka Spooks, of course, like the Rotary that he will reveal many, many, many things, will expose the entire country, PH, of thieves, bandits, and kidnappers, so the country goes bankrupt. No more investors. So ordered the pistolero. He didn't even spare his Americans' clients threatening to file charges against them for estafa fraud, because they didn't pay their bill to Sticky Media Solutions. Which one? What a big laugh we had, LOL. And the apocalypse now? So guys, who is Mike Mountstephen, aka Spooks, Michael's best friend and partner in crime? Well, it looks like he wasn't liked either, and the expats over in the Philippines would also post about Mike. Mike was a private members bar owner in the Philippines and would supply women for free to the members as seen in his emails. Wink, wink. Now where have we seen a private club before guys and girls? No, it wouldn't be the Circle nightclub in Greater Manchester, would it? No, surely not. This all just coincidences. But we carry on, and one man would respond to Mike, aka Spooks, on this post with the following, now Mike Mountstephen. AKA Spooks, the real reason I'm here today is to answer to this portion of your message to me. Ask Evan Iliadis. He may, if he ever does return, be taking a very keen interest in this act, especially its pointy end. Asking you, what makes you believe that I will not come back? What makes you believe that the provision on e-libel included in the new bill is applied to someone like me that went out of his way to bring 175,000 readers around the world, half of them from the PH, that read about you and your team of pimps and supporters can be at risk? Again, will you find a judge to side with you when I'll present 180 notarized statements you have made on the net and others as well about you while in dialogue with you? Or you maybe think that a few sexpats like you, say five or six, got together and shot down a few old blogs that were irrelevant anyway, since Paul Petraea is now history, and the others were mostly on Chris Bennett's Will Slow Down, Evan? Or you think the power of Commander Gunther Vomberg did the trick? Or Matt Wilkie's barking from the Desert of Omen had any effect? None. This blog also may come down. So what? It's an old site that needs maintenance. I and partners decided to let it go and build a new one. Bigger, with space for everyone. Stay tuned, you'll be amongst the first to be notified. Priority always is given to senior citizens and old residents. Mike Mountstephen, aka Spooks, I am here to inform you that, yes, I will return, very soon. With new buildings where, of course, you'll have your own private room as a tribute for being a longtime resident. In closing, I would appreciate if you can answer again the question of this Flock Together forum made of you. So as you can see, Michael Allen's SEO companies were a front for a human trafficking organization, i.e., an illegal escort agency for a private members club, or the very least, his partner in crime was the owner of that bar. Now, Michael Allen Turner would go on to cause many more crimes in the Philippines, such as murder, where a police officer was arrested alongside him, drug possession of cocaine and more, and was even caught with the date rape drug, GHB. Why would anyone need GHB, guys? And was eventually murdered alongside his 19-year-old wife of 4 years. Do the maths, guys? She also 14, 15 when they got married, let alone when they met. That's pedophilia and statutory rape. But Tron, can you connect Michael Allen Turner to smugglers and traffickers, I hear you ask? For fuck's sake, guys, do I ever let you down?
Kalambigitan sa gisuspetsahang car smuggler Leonard Allen Bigcas. Usa ka lang yaw ang nagreklamo nga gipusil ni Bigcas. Apan buwelta ni Bigcas, wa siya namusil. Uga tumo-tumo rin istorya ang nagreklamo kaniya. Nagapatrol Maricel Butardo.
Nagpablatay sa Carmen Police Station sa Cagayan de Oro ang usaka Amerikano nga si Michael Turner. Unod sa iyang reklamo ang matod papagpamusil kaniya ni Leonard Allen Bigcas, Hunyo 3 sa gabi sa may Kauswagan Highway. Butang nga hingpit gimakak ni Bigcas. Bigcas, gikasuko ni Turner ang usa ka higayon nga gipaninglan kini niya sa bayad sa giutang ni ining motorsiklo.
Alis niya ko ning to Michael Turner gi kusila sa ni Alan Bigcas. Pero pag inistiwas tong sako, gitan ang sakyan, wala man sa igo.
Abi na, may bangga, grabe, kaya mura, bitaw na ibangga nga, grabe kayong lo, sa break. Pagawas na po, ano may police din na ito mga around 8 or 9, ana. Diyara, kung ako kamulungan na, buto kayo, sabak mo kayo mga sakyan na mga dag,
ang nagulong ko na ito. Na paghatag pahayag si Turner kalabot sa isyu. Apan laraw matod pa niyang mapasakag kaso o galing di sila magka-aregyo ni Bigcas. Maricel Butardo Patrol sa Northern Mindanao.
Sulay mga balita, dunay mga dokumento, mga text message.
So now we know that Martin has connections that can control even the law enforcement officers in the Philippines and can personally instruct raids and get away with murder. So let's take our pens once more and add some more crumbs to this spider's web of idiots. 1. Michael Turner brought Karate Marty and Hans to the Philippines. 2. Michael ran a sham front SEO company. 3. Karate Marty has connections to people in very high places that can control the local police force to the point of instructing raids. 4. Michael is a pedophile who married his wife at 14 or 15, but must have met her way before that to even get to the point of marriage. 5. Karate Marty is a bitch. 6. Michael's best friend owned and ran a private bar where would supply escorts to his members for free. 7. Michael had ties to smugglers and human traffickers. And let's take another look at the graph, shall we, and see where we are at with this spider's web of idiots. So for the regulars in this dark corner of YouTube, now you know why Deca Hegi wouldn't get his passport. Well, would you? When the man holding your passport has connections like Marty does.
I do roll with the big boys. I really do.
And you hold the information to expose an elite, serious underground network, and you're on your own in a foreign country, and no one is believing a word you say anyway. They would have killed Deka Hegyi, or at least could have, and used connections in the police force to get away with it, like Michael Allen, Turner Karate Marty's friend. Holding the passport was a setup, guys, and I don't even think Deka knows the extent of what's going on over there and took Big Dumb straight in the middle of it all expecting a fight. Well, there may have been plans for an actual fight, but the true reason I feel was to try set Deka up with an underage girl, and it backfired, and Deka made a run for it fast, seeing what was happening, and left his passport amongst other thing behind, and is too scared to tell the full truth. But isn't it strange that anyone in the world could have sponsored Deka Hegyi's YouTube channel, but no one was, until Karate Marty pops up, who just so happens to be a friend of Humble and also has a pedophile ring and Freemason connection. I also feel Deka knows more but has been worried to expose what he knows this whole time and how bad it really is, or that Humble had said something to Deka on drugs or drunk, like when Humble was investigated for pedophilia and told a friend's brother information.
And I've been accused of like telling somebody's brother who's got a rape of children.
But no, it's just all another coincidence, isn't it, guys, girls, and none of this true, and none of this can be found online by you right now. But look at the extent of this campaign, and then we look at all the people who have supported them and how they all know Humble personally and has done strange shit and not just shoplifting. Now, hey guys, Danny Christie, his past is weird, from drugging women to causing nerve damage on women and running a cocaine line for Humble and letting Humble pump him full of coke. And Video Craig with jokes about dead kids and uploading pornographic material online of an ex to get back at her. I mean, who does that shit and has a tattoo of a dead baby? But what an album cover to choose for a tattoo. Hey, Craig, like everyone would see, it's an album cover. It's just a dead baby, you freak. Or Tony Burkett, who was in jail twice for attempted rape. Are you still not seeing the big picture yet, guys? This some serious shit, but it's all just coincidence once again that Humble bumps into people like this. He's a good guy whose social circle are not questionable while being obsessed with grasses and going against a man who's talking about an elite pedo ring because he other reasons to hate knowing it could shit on the information Patty's giving to everyone about these things. Why would he do that, hey guys? I wonder why. It seems everyone he knows on YouTube has some strange crimes against women, but always has an excuse why they are innocent. Deka knows something, guys and girls. I don't know what he knows and what he knows, but it's valuable to the police. And there is a huge investigation into the circle worldwide, and especially in the Philippines, as we've seen from the Savage Girl news article where they mentioned her tag name on purpose and mentioned they had warned women in the area of the Circle Club. So ask yourself, could Marty have the connections or the ability to get Deka arrested and set up now that we know what we know about his connections? But why is Deka still there? I feel Deka's about to something he should have done a long time ago and assist an investigation, and the Philippine authorities now have someone who holds a lot of the information they need and seen how the network worked by fixing him up with false charges and embarrassing the nation on live TV when the UK authorities totally denied all charges against Deka and have sent someone from the UK embassy to assist. You see, Marty, when I start research, I like to search and search until I find the weak points. But the spider's web is just getting bigger and bigger with you, and I suddenly realized this whole time that the weak point was you. Now, before we say goodbye, I managed to get a personal message from the one and only Humble Dryer. Take it away, Humble.
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it.
Ice, ice, baby. Ice, ice, baby.
All right, stop. Collaborate and listen. Ice is back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights
and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance, caress a speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly, when I play a dope melody. Anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it, you better gain weight. You better hit bulls out of kid, don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. MCs like a pound of bacon, burning them, getting quick and nimble. I go crazy when I hear a cymbal and a hi-hat with a souped-up tempo. I'm on a roll, it's time to go solo. Rollin', hit my 5.0, put my rag top down so my hair can blow. The girlie's on standby, waiting just to say hi.
Did you stop?
No, I just drove by, kept on, pursuing to the next stop. I bust a left and I'm heading to the next block. The block was dead, yo, so I continue to A1A. Girls were hot, wearing less than bikinis. Rock men love us, driving Lamborghinis.
Jealous,
cause I'm out getting mine. Shade with the gauge and vanilla with the nine. Ready for the chumps on the wall. The chumps acting ill because they're full of eight ball. Gunshots ranged out like a bell. I grabbed my nine, all I heard was shells falling on the concrete real fast. Jumped in my car, slammed on the gas. Bumper to bumper, the avenue's packed. I'm trying to get away before the jack is jacked.
Police on the scene,
you know what I mean? They passed me up, could run it all, the dope fiends. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. Take heed, cause I'm a lyrical poet. Miami's on the scene, just in case you didn't know it. Rhymes you can vision and feel. Conducted in form, this is a hell of a concept. We make it hype, and you want us to print this. Shape plays on a fade, slice like a ninja, cut like a razor blade so fast. Other DJs say, damn, a rhyme was a drug, I'd sell it by the gram. Keep my composure when it's time to get loose. Magnetized by the mic while I kick my juice. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while DJ revolves it. Get out of here. Word to your mother.
Ice, ice, baby.
Well, somebody's asked, Humble, are you a Freemason?
Yes, I am, mate, aye. I've not been for years, but I'm a Freemason, yeah.
All right, aye, because, you know, Gary's a Freemason. I was going to ask him about that. Ask Gary about that a little bit.
Yeah, well, Gary only told me last year that he was. I didn't know Gary was in the Masons. It was Steve Rafe that brought it up. I think, I'm not sure if, does Gary go at the same...
And that, my friends, is how you stick breadcrumbs together to create a slice of bread, using a spider's web of idiots. And Danny, recently you made a video saying men who can't fight are inferior. Well, Danny, I'm about as hard as a jam sponge, mate, and look what I just did. While you was training to be hard, other people learned legit skills. You ended up getting punched for living. I sit at my desk and earn way more than you do. I know who I'd rather be. And Brett, you're next. Operation Brett May is in full swing. You see, you went way too far and terrified and man's wife on her birthday, whether you want to have arrangements or not. You went too far, and I seen your gun in the car, and everyone backed you. But me and Paul share a commonality that we both have autistic daughters and are a part of a small community. And just for that, Operation Brett May is in full swing. Now, it's been a while, but this one's just for you, Brett.
Yo, come again. Listen, yo, look.
You know me, I'm the hard food mover, the start night shooter, the MAC-10's loaded with bolts and the Luger. Think that you're hard, but I see right through ya. I'm your worst nightmare, you can call me the 08 Kruger. I can't be a loser, I win, win, win. A serious face, I don't grin, grin, grin. I'm hard with a gash, I can never be sweet. I don't sing, sing, sing. Couple man when I run around spitting by eyes they got. I can't see no bling, bling, bling. Their waist like they jump like the bin, bin, bin. Waist like they jump like the trash. Me, I just jump at the cab all covered in black. When I jump back in, I got peas in the bag. That's how I get down on rags. I roll with the 3/8 strap all covered in black. From the barrel to the hammer that gets pulled back. When I line up a man, look at his head back. Bet he'll get much more than his head crack. Car bullets do kill, that's a well-known fact. So you can try act in front of your friends, but after you're slumped, then I'm dumping at them. I swear man done got hotted on air, but now take a look, he's fun air again. So no, they don't really want it with a boy. They talk tough, but they can never run it to the boy. 38 stub nose in the waist when I'm up in the place. That's why they ain't on it with a boy. Make him run like Sonic from the boy. So you can be a fuck in your bits, but it won't mean shit when I let a man die like